And welcome back to IEMG for a very special Fall League Champions edition of Sports Weekly. We have got the San Andreas League champions and, more importantly, the CIF Southern Section Division 7 champions in the house here at IEMG, the San Gorgonio Spartans. First off, congratulations, guys. Coach Gehringer.
Thank you.
First CIF title for the school in football, right? Your first title as a head coach. How special was that victory against Norda Vista, Coach?
Well, it was a great game. Our kids fought all the way. We had some adversity, put the ball on the ground. Our defense did a tremendous job. The Norda Vista running back, Eric, is a great football player. But, you know, we had him to half his average, and it was a very satisfying win. And the offense came through at the end, made some plays, and got it to overtime. And then we did a tremendous job of winning and causing a turnover so we could get the football back, and then we punched it in. So it was a tremendous feeling, to say
that. It was an instant classic. I think everyone there at the game was like, wow, this is one of the greatest games you're going to see. You brought some of the guys here.
Yes.
We got JR on the end, who's the MVP, right, of the San Andreas
League. San Andreas League MVP, offensive tackle. Done a great job for us all year long. I think he's a next-level kind of football player. Mean, nasty. Did a great job for us.
He looks nice.
Yeah.
Hey, but talk about the offense and paving the way for guys like Day-Day, and of course Xavier Leslie is not here with us right now, but I mean, obviously you got to get the ground game going, right, free it up so Caleb can throw the ball as well.
Yeah, we had to get the ground game going. We just had to point out who we got, just basically just so they could run the ball.
All right, we also got Caleb Hayes, the quarterback, over here. You and Tyreek Jones have formed a pretty good combination here, especially in the playoffs right now, the quarterback-receiver duo. What's been clicking between you two guys right now, Caleb?
We're just best friends now, I feel, and we just talk to each other. If I mess up, he'll talk to me, and if he'll mess up, well, it hardly happens. I'll tell him, like, you know, what's happening. So,
you guys best friends?
I see us more as brothers.
There you go. That's even better. That's even better.
Yeah, even brothers. Family.
So, Tyreek, are you the guy that says, you know what, Caleb, just put that ball up. I'll get underneath it. Don't worry about me. You just want the ball to make a play, right?
Yeah, I tell him all the time, man. Even when he'll turn it over or whatever, you know, I yell at him, but at the end of the day, it's tough love, man.
Brothers, right? I mean, brothers don't always get along, right? I mean, we got Montre, it's kind of sandwiching me some linebackers. Hey, let me ask Montre real quick. Yes. Going back to that Norda Vista game, man, and winning the CIF title, how cool was it to not only win the CIF, but you guys were on your home field, the first time Sanji's hosted a championship game. How special was that moment?
Oh, it was real special. That game was crazy. Stands was packed, so I feel like we lost. We was going to let down a lot of people, so, yeah, pretty much we had to win.
Montre, let me ask you, as the season progressed, did you feel like the team was getting better and better week by week, kind of peaking as you got to that championship game?
Yeah, I think, yeah, we got better and better, but it's, every week we faced adversity, so pretty much.
All right, Day-Day over here is dying to get on the microphone and talk. Dejon Williams, Day-Day Williams, running back, linebacker. How's your knee doing?
It's doing all right? Real good. I went to the doctor, and I got to wear this little ugly boot thing.
Yeah.
I'm supposed to be on crutches, but she said if it doesn't hurt too much, then I can
just go for it, right?
Yeah.
So how bad did you want to play in that championship game? I know if you're a little banged up and whatever, you still got to play, right?
I wasn't going out that game. Caleb even came up to me. He said, you're not getting out the game. Get your helmet back in. Which I was thinking, but Miss Courtney, she was holding me down. No, you can't go, but I was ready to go. I didn't care.
So you played a lot on defense. You got, I think, a couple carries, right? Or was it all Xavier in that championship game?
Xavier, yeah, like two or three.
Okay, so, and then over here, your guy in the linebacking unit, Gabriel Murgo over here. You know, you go into the game, you know Eric Malesio from Norda Vista was going to get a ton of touches on that ball. What was the game plan going in to slow him down?
Well, my job was to play backside, so I just had to make sure I was slow playing the backside, so if he cut back, I was there to take on the blocks and, you know, also just make plays.
So, Coach, you won 22 straight games in San Andreas League play.
Yes.
Four straight undefeated league titles.
Right.
How important is it for you guys in the program to just kind of keep that going? You don't want to be the team, right, to drop the ball and lose a league game or not win a league title. I mean, you got a good thing going right now.
Well, we got a good thing going. The league has lost some teams. We used to have Carter in there and Caron. We played really well in the league, but more importantly, we've set goals to reach a higher standard. We went to the semis, and now we won a CIF title. I think that helps us a great deal in what we're trying to establish here. We're trying to get kids to understand that even though we're from San Bernardino, we can make things happen, and, mm-hmm. and we're doing a great job of making things happen.
Now, we've been talking all season long,
right.
since the summer, and you like this group.
Right.
You probably envisioned yourself being here. Do you think maybe some other people are like, San Gorgonio, I don't know. I mean, you guys were always ranked in Division 7. You were always right there. But at the end, do you think a lot of people were like, man, San G, they were for real?
Well, I think we had to convince some people.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, last year we were 7-4, and we lost in the first round, and we lost to the CBL fourth place team. We thought we had something to prove. We had a little bit of a chip on our shoulder. We played well against the preseason competition this year. The only game that we really didn't play well was the Oak Hill game. But we had a goal, and we were able to achieve it. The bottom line to all this is that we had no control of where they put us, but we had control of ourselves, and we had the opportunity to win, and we took advantage of it.
That Oak Hills game was the third of three straight losses
right.
for you guys. It could have been easy for this team to fold up and say, you know what, we're really not as good as we thought we were, or we're going to turn the corner and get back on track, and
right.
that's exactly what you guys did. Did
right.
you see it as a turning point?
Well, I think the Oak Hills was the lowest point of the season. It was the only time that we really didn't play real competitive football. We had to play just before halftime. We made a mistake, and I think our kids kind of just, you know, fell apart. But you know, we got in the league, we got some momentum going, kind of hyped us up a little bit when we played the Rupert Hills.
Yeah.
And, you know, because it was a competitive situation, our kids played really well. And then, you know, when the playoffs started, I still think the best 12 minutes of football we played was the first game in the playoffs against South Hills.
Yeah.
We put 35 points up against them.
I was at that one.
Scored on our first six possessions, and we played defense really well. And this group has just been excellent. I think that's the bigger picture. Everybody grew. Mm-hmm. We had some issues. We had some circumstances that we could have fell apart. But everybody grew, and everybody improved. And this group of guys really carried us to another level as far as San G football is concerned.
Probably testament to their perseverance, right?
Oh, I mean, no doubt about
staying
it.
Staying the course.
Yes. I mean, I could say great things about everybody. Caleb is going to Oregon State, an outstanding athlete, super speed. I think when he turned the corner against South Hills, everybody, you know, I think it made the South Hill guys quick because they didn't see anybody like that. Day-Day has been the guy who's all year long been the physical guy. Come in, he makes a lot of plays offensively and defensively. He had 18 tackles in the game against Nota Vista. Gabriel has been Mr. Consistent, and he's always going to give you 15 a game. Montre has been the quiet leader. I mean, he puts us in the right defense, but, I mean, what a game he played the other night.
Mm-hmm.
Tyreek has been on a tear.
Yeah. These
killing
two,
guys.
Yeah.
You know, before this past game, Caleb had four games of 200 yards of passing or more, and Tyreek's got 14 touchdowns catching over 1,000 yards. You can't say anything about that except that he's killing guys, you know, and he's a hard. And honestly, he put us in a great situation in the Nota Vista game because they were double covering him, and it opened up some
Someone's
things for us.
Be open, right?
It opened up some opportunities for the other guys. And then JR has been Mr. McNasty. He's been
happens up front, right? We all know what happens in the trenches.
He's been the blind side 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I mean, every time you turn on the film, he's taking somebody 10 to 15 yards downfield.
Yeah.
And it has and what's All-CIF player last year will be again this year.
Yeah, and the San Andreas League MVP. It's worth repeating.
Right.
That's pretty cool. Guys, congratulations on the San Andreas League title and the CIF Southern Section Division 7 crown. Pretty big, pretty special for San Bernardino and, of course, San Gorgonio High. So congrats, Coach G. We appreciate
you
taking the time to come down
Thank
here.
Thank you.
All right, that's going to do it for this Fall League Champions edition of Sports Weekly here on IEMG. I'm Pep Fernandez, and for everyone here at the Inland Empire Media Group, we appreciate you watching. Please subscribe to the YouTube channel, and we'll see you next time.